This is the segue Nanbot. Alright, today we want to be discussing Skui Scooters. Instead, we'll focus on its latest products, the Segway Cube Series. A super durable, aesthetically pleasing, and highly modular power station. You can use it to create a power hose with a capacity of up to 5 kilowatts hour, and it even comes with a mobile app. The best part, in my opinion, is the price. I got the Segway Cube 2000, which offers a 2 kilowatts hour capacity for only $999. Believe me, typically a capacity like this costs much more. So buying it is a real saving, and I'll provide the link in the description. So make sure to check it out before you miss this fantastic opportunity. I've been using the Segway Cube for about a week now, and this video I'll give you my full review, including the pros and cons. Please watch to the end for my conclusion. Starting with the unboxing experience, we find a compact box containing a detailed English manual, an Allen key inside the bag, as well as both a car charging and a wall charging cable. The model I received is the Cube 2000, boasts a 2 kilowatts hour capacity, and it's worth noting that it's quite heavy. So it's quite advisable either lay it down or seek assistance from a friend when taken out of the box. Additionally, I also received SP200 solar panel, which I believe is a must-have for harnessing clean energy, don't you think? Now, let's dive into the design of the power station. Please keep in mind that I'm currently located in China, so I requested a fish to ship the version with the Chinese sockets. However, you can always order the type that suits your country. Starting from the top, you'll notice the inverter along with the two handles, making it easier to carry. Additionally, there is an LCD screen that displays various parameters, but I'll get into that in a moment. For those curious about the ports on the cube, here's what we've got. 3 AC outlets, 2 30.6 voltage 5 amp DC outlets, which are protected by the cover. There's also a core outlet, 2 100 watts Type-C ports, and 4 18 watts USB-A ports, all located under another cover. Turning to the back, you'll find overload protector, an AC fast charging port, and a solar core input. This covers the basic set of ports on the cube. While it may not have the most extensive array of ports, it's certainly sufficient, especially considering its compact size. Regarding other design elements, there is a ventilation system on the side and 4 rubber pads on each side. This thoughtful design allows for flexibility in placement, such as in the core trunk, where it can rest horizontally without interfering with the trunk lid. As I mentioned earlier, one of the standout features of the Segway Cube is its modular design. With Allen key tool included in the box, you can easily disassemble and assemble it within minutes. The best part, it's completely wireless, eliminating those annoying wires from the equation. So that covers the overall design of the Segway Cube. Thanks to its magnesium alloy M60B skeleton shell design, the cube looks incredibly sleek, durable, and high-tech. It seamlessly blends into any setting in my house and complements the decor perfectly. When it comes to using the Segway Cube, I have to say it's probably one of the easiest electronic devices I've ever operated. On the front panel, you'll find a power button. Simply press and hold it for 2 seconds, and the cube will power on automatically. There are also AC outlet and DC outlet buttons right there. Just press them once to activate, and you're good to go. For instance, the other day I was out testing it to charge my e-bike. I used one of the AC outlets and it charged in seconds, allowing me to enjoy my journey without worrying about the battery. Now, a little bit more about LCD screen. Some key spec icons on the screen are quite self-explanatory. Out and in indicate output and input power, respectively. The percentage represents how much battery juice is left. For the rest, I just list them on the screen. Another fantastic feature is that the Cube supports its self-developed app. It's an intuitive app that effortlessly provides access to all the key information you need. You can also adjust the settings such as fan mode, hard drive, and the UPS through the app. While the app offers detailed functionality, I won't dive into all the details in this video as it would make this endless. Now, let's put the thing to test. First up, solar charging. Actually, it was the first thing I tried when this device arrived at my studio. So now the solar panel is straightforward. Just angle it towards the sunlight and connect to the solar input. Then we can see the charging icon lights up, indicating that we are successfully charging the power station. Simultaneously, we can see the input power, which is a floating point value because sunlight intensity varies. When there are no clouds blocking the sun, you'll get a better input power. During my testing, I saw the peak at as much as 145 watts when the sunlight was strong, but dropped as low as 11 watts in less ideal conditions. Regardless, I managed to charge from 24% to 46% in 3 hours during my testing, which is quite normal considering the less than ideal weather at the time. No complaints there. I also tested how long it takes to charge the cube from 11% to 100% using wall charging. I took about 1.5 hours. The input power can reach up to 1,600 watts at the beginning, which is quite impressive. Of course, with the fast charging technology, the initial part of the charging process is always the fastest, and then it gradually slows down. Nevertheless, the charging speeds are commendable. The second thing we tested when reviewing a power station is its maximum load capacity. According to the official information, the Cube series can deliver up to 2,200 watts of power via AC. To put this to the test, I plug in a microwave and a kettle and I reached 2,192 watts without any problems. I was able to heat pizza and prepare some food while boiling water simultaneously. The best part I claim is the all drive function, which allows you to power high power devices of up to 4,400 watts. What this means is that it automatically adjusts the output power to accommodate AC devices that exceed the rated output, ensuring they work properly. I tried using a 1,200 watts microwave, a 1,500 watts kettle, and a 1,800 watts hairdryer, and they all operated correctly. We can observe that the on icon automatically appears on the screen, indicating that the on drive mode is active. Another noteworthy feature I want to mention is the UPS, uninterrupted power supply. I put this to the test as well. I connect the cube to the wall socket, which was drawing power from the grid, and then I connected a refrigerator to the cube. Afterward, I intentionally cut off the grid power, and it worked like a charm. This is excellent for those who want to keep something important in the refrigerator but worry about unexpected grid power failures. The Cube's UPS feature can be a lifesaver in such situations. When reviewing products like this, I always prioritize safety and thermal performance. While I cannot dismantle it for penetration experiments, it's essential to know that the Cube is equipped with lithium iron phosphate batteries sourced from the UL certified automotive grade lithium iron phosphate power cells. This choice should ensure safety. I trust Segway number on this because I've tested numerous of the e-scooters before and have been impressed with the quality. Regarding thermal performance, I measured the temperature after subjecting it to the heavy max loading test, and the maximum temperature I observed was around 28 degrees Celsius, which is quite impressive. To put it into perspective, a hair dryer can reach almost 200 degrees, and boiling water is over 90 degrees. For those concerned about noise levels, it's at an average home noise level, which is definitely acceptable. I can even place it in my bedroom and use it during sleep without any issues. Now, my conclusion. It's been a while since I've been this excited about a product because, unlike many electronics I reviewed in the past, I know that with the Segway Cube Power Station, I can use it in my daily life. I've reviewed plenty of large power stations before, and compared to those, this one seems much more affordable and far less intimidating. It's easy to use with no need for complex installations. One of its standout features is its portability, making it easy to carry when I go camping. It fits effortlessly in the car trunk. However, speaking of portability, my only complaint, and perhaps the only downside to this product, is that you have to purchase the small wheel cart shown in the official video. And you know what? They have it! It is practically a must-have. With it, you can save yourself a lot of trouble. I consider myself strong, but carrying it for an extended period during the review almost killed me. So make sure to get the wheel cart. I understand that for many people, it may not be necessary to carry such a power station with you for every outdoor activity. You might opt for more batteries or portable solutions that can last you one or two additional days. However, with the Segway Power Station Cube, your trips and adventures become more enjoyable, immersive, and hassle-free. It's undoubtedly a must-have for outdoor enthusiasts. If you are interested in this product, please check out the link in the description. Don't miss out. Thanks for watching. I'm Sammy. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Okay.